So that was, like, very enjoyable. I want to talk about my experience here at Daniel Pearl and how it impacted my life. Because, like, I was, like, a very lonely person. Coming here to Daniel Pearl, like, they made me, like, the students made me feel welcome. And I really had an enjoyable year.
Yes, Daniel Pearl is a very close school. Everyone here knows each other. The staff are going to be very close to you. And talking about staff, we want to thank a bunch of them. For example, Miss Ruiz, who is our
school mom, our mama shark. Yeah, we
yes,
want to thank her for her close bond with the graduates. We want to thank her for always being there for us if we need a shoulder to cry on. She's always there for us. She's very supportive. Without her, the school wouldn't be the same.
Yes, Miss Ruiz and other staff have also stated how they will miss the graduates this year and that the graduates are very happy for this new chapter in their life, but they will miss the school as well.
Miss Ruiz also helped with grad night along with Miss Tool. They went to grad night. They stayed up until 3 in the morning. Like, do that for students, you know? Mm-hmm. So they're very much appreciated.
Yes, and Miss Torres as well for helping our graduates here get into a good college and really just follow their dreams.
Yeah, without the school, again, Miss Torres, it's going to be the same. We love her very much, and she's very appreciative. I love how Ms. Torres always has a smile every day, even though she does so much for the school.
Yes.
The only counselor, and even though we have a few students, well, she really does a lot, and I just want to put this down.
And we also want to thank Ms. Lupe and Ms. Martha.
And Ms. Miranda.
Yes, and Ms. Miranda.
For
both, yes.
So much for the school. They have done so much. Ms. Martha, by keeping the school very safe. Miss Miranda and Miss Lupe by working in the front office.
Yes, and our lunch ladies as well for always being there to serve us food and just keep us there energized.
Yeah.
And with Miss Miranda, it is her first year here, and she states that she will miss the graduates very much and that she appreciates her time here at school.
Last week, there was elections for ASB, and Maggie Simonian won president. One vice president. I, Alejandra Iniguez, won secretary, and Nat Lembo won treasurer.
Yes, and for the National Honor Society, we want to thank Miss B for being there to help us, and just overall, the Honor Society helps unite so many more people.
As we're getting ready, we see students in the NPR ready to walk on stage. We're very,
yes,
we're very emotional.
We see the parents talking about being emotional.
Yeah.
Our staff was getting very emotional as they were explaining the departure of our graduates. And the graduates overall have made many memories. Going back to the senior prank this year, the senior prank involved messing with the rooms and decorating the halls. It was very memorable.
Yeah. We also want to give a huge shout out to Mr. Petrosian.
Yes.
For all the things he did.
Yes, for being the principal. And we also want to thank Mr. Hambright and Mr. Middlebrook.
For making graduation.
Yes, for being able to record this, we thank Mr. Middlebrook. And for the music, we thank Mr. Hambright here. And the students that are helping as well, behind the cameras. And, yes.
As we were talking to graduates, we asked them how they felt about leaving Daniel Pearl. And they said that they're very sad because they're leaving all of their friends. And they feel very nervous because they have to adapt to new schedules and meeting new individuals.
Yes, our valedictorian of this year is Delilah Broomer, and she stated the same. And we will miss her very much because she has done a lot for this school.
Like, done a lot of events. She's always there.
She's always behind it all. She's there helping us well. And that's one of the memories we will miss from the graduates.
Officers is Angela. Sam is treasurer.
Mm-hmm.
Sabrina is vice president. And Delilah Broomer is secretary. And I just want to give a huge shout out to them. Because, like, without them, the school would be not as enjoyable. They have planned out dances, activities in the front grove, so very much appreciated. And
yes,
the school is not going to be the same without them. We're going to miss them a lot.
Yes, we are. And although the school is a little little small. We here at Daniel Pearl Magnet High School are very close to each other. We offer many programs. So if you're into writing, we have our journalism program, into taking photos, whether it be selfies or taking photos of someone else or other things such as even trees. Ms. Shavira is here to help you. She is a great photography teacher.
Yeah. We also want to thank Ms. Shavira.
Yes.
She has done so much for the school too.
Yes, and Ms. Helfing.
We were talking to Ms. Helfing, and she said she feels happy for the graduates, but sad at the same time. Letting go.
Yes. And as we were interviewing, some seniors were there talking with her, and you could see the close bond that they have, as many teachers do here with our school.
I just want to talk about how Daniel Pearl is a very small school, but everybody's united. It's a small community, but has amazing classes. We take AP, there's college places.
Yes. Yes, and here at Daniel Pearl, we have much more opportunities to be able to take these classes. And Ms. Helfing, for example, will be teaching the new African American Studies class, and we are very excited for that. And our upcoming seniors, juniors, sophomores, and freshmen.
Yeah. talk about Ms. Kathy and her.
Yes.
It's her last year here at Daniel Pearl.
Yes.
So we're very sad about that because she made the school feel very welcome.
Yes, every teacher here has had an impact on any student. Whether that student not talk much to the teachers, we see that they have an impact, and that every teacher or staff that we've interviewed has a very close bond with our graduates, and we will miss our graduates dearly.
Our senior student-to-be senior class is selling snacks. Cupcakes. So you guys can go buy some and support our senior class for next year to do more activities, more dances.
Yes, and the upcoming activities will be held by Maggie. Yes.
Jasmine Arevalo. Oh wait, Valerio, me, Alejandra Inez, and Natalia Lembo. And as we see, the seniors are walking.
They are walking down the halls right now.
To the hall, ready to graduate.
They are on to their final stage.
I'm actually going to miss them, and I'm actually going to cry because I have a lot of memories with them.
Yes, they are walking down currently, and we will miss them very much.
Very proud of them. Daniel Pearl is very proud of them. A lot of students got accepted to UCLA, USC.
Yes, prestige colleges, and all thanks to the help of the staff and students here at school.
All thanks to the staff and hard work.
Although it might be a small school, all the students here receive immense help from everyone. And yes, we are just very, very close.
I want to thank our video production crew.
Yes, for being here and setting everything up from getting here at 2. We have been here working very hard, and we want to give a shout out to them and to everyone that's helped set everything up, including Mr. Hambright's students who came here and are going to perform wonderful music for the parents and the graduates.
We want to thank Sarah Gomez, Christian Mateo, Cynthia Rendon, Jenny
Lopez,
and Andrew Arlo,
and Derek
Velasquez.
And Andre and Anthony.
We also want to thank our students that are taking pictures of graduation.
Yes, they will. Once again, talking about photography at Daniel Pearl, we release a magazine every few months, every month or so, and we get to see the diverse art skills of students, their writing skills. People could join into the club that Ms. Shavira holds, which is a writing class, and there they could write and as well write it, put it in the magazine. And we have won many awards for being a journalism school.
Delilah placed second place in LA Times for her article.
Yes, and many of our artists here at school are working with prestige networks, and they are getting very far here at Daniel Pearl Magnet High School.
I also want to say that our journalism club goes to the many conventions, and we practice through writing, reading, art, animation, articles. They practice all of that. And
yes, and photography. Photography is a big thing. As we are a journalism-based school, many of our writers here have gotten the opportunity to show and express their talents, as well as our photographers here.
That's one thing I like about Daniel Pearl. That
yes, this school is very much run by the students, I would say. A lot of our events and everything is usually being held by students. For example, when we had our convention, or the auction it was, there were many students there holding. I was there as well.
The PearlCon?
Yes, yeah. PearlCon.
We were helping, selling food. It
yes,
was really
raising
fun
money for the school. Yes, and
fun, like making memories with our friends, other students. It
being
was
there to support the school overall. It's all a very great community, and it's good.
Yeah,
here at Daniel.
It made
Pearl.
Me very happy to see all the students, seniors, sophomores, freshmen, helping out with the school. It just, I don't know. Very
yes,
like,
and as a small base school, we get the chance to interact with many more people. For example, I've interacted with people. Alejandra, I didn't think I would be with her, but I'm here talking with her and other people that I didn't think I would be able to interact with. And that's a good thing here at Daniel Pearl. You could interact and talk to many different people.
I want to give credit for photographers. Desiree, Rika,
Alan. Yes.
Yeah. We also want to thank the music department for singing and songs such as
Beat It. Oh, yes. Our song list. We have.
We'll tell you who's performing.
Yes,
we'll
tell you once they're performing.
David, Leron. They're all performing tonight.
Mose, yes.
We're very excited.
Yes,
awesome.
Our students hold many events like this. For example, World Music Day is something we hold where our students perform, and they just really show off their talents, singers such as Alejandra. And we are here due to Daniel Pearl.
I also want to say Maggie Simonian, our ASB president for next year, is going to be speaking. So very excited to hear that.
Yes, our speech is from our graduates, and it's going to be very emotional because our
as we say,
yes, our
we
teachers
have a lot
are
of
close
memories with them. As we were like talking to teachers, they were saying how they're very happy but sad.
They all gave similar reactions, and it's what we expected of how comforting it is to know that they are very close with the students, and we don't go to school thinking that they don't care about us. We know that we always have someone that we could talk to.
And as we're speaking, we have Miss Miranda.
Yes, Miss Miranda.
This is her first
wonderful
year.
Yes.
Yeah. Miss Miranda. No, come, Miss Miranda.
Yes, let us interview you.
How do you feel about students graduating this year?
Well, I'm going to miss them. And I'm going to miss them. But I'm so
here
proud of them. We're
yes, yes.
How do you feel about students graduating?
Happy and a little bit excited because, you know, I had them for 4 years, so I guess this is a congratulations, and I'll see you guys soon, I guess.
I'm just anxious. I want to make sure this is perfect.
Yes.
So, sorry.
No, okay. Miss Miranda, this is your first year working here.
Yes, and Miss Lupe, our...
They work in the front.
Yes.
And we're so happy to...
And our janitors are all, yes.
Without Sal, the school
would be a mess.
Be
our Luce, school appreciates.
We want to give a shout out to Sal and Miss Luce for helping our school feel like home. Making our school look clean. Well, wait, it is clean.
And yes, our wonderful school will be kept clean.
See the seniors.
And the graduates, yes, yes, our graduates, they have the music starting right now of them walking down, and we are very, very excited to see them.
Their students walk down and ready to graduate. We're so excited, and I just want to wish our graduates the best. We're going to miss them, and the school is going to be the same without them. I don't want to get emotional, but I want to give a big shout out to Nayama, Angela, and Sammy for making me feel welcomed when I came here to Daniel Pearl.
Yes, much of luck to our graduates, and we appreciate every single one of you guys and for everything you did. Our seniors are currently walking down.
Oh, the teachers.
Yes, Ms. Torres, yes. Okay.
I'm getting emotional, very close with the seniors, and I'm so glad I've made so many memories.
Yes, the memories here. Yes, they are going
to walk
down. Great.
As you can see them, Mr. McCann is a teacher. He's one of the new teachers here at Daniel Pearl.
One of our new English teachers. Yes, a very loved teacher, as well as Miss G.
Miss Hurtado.
Miss Hurtado,
yes. Only teacher here at Daniel Pearl that teaches Spanish. So we're very grateful for her.
Yes, very grateful. Yes, yes, yes.
Students wouldn't be graduating right now because they need 2 years of language.
Yes.
From Ms. Dado, Ms.
Okay, so we want to thank our graduates and everything, and best of luck. Thank you.
Bye. Have a great year.
A great year.
Good evening. I am Maggie Simonian, student body president for the 2023 to 2024 school year. Please join in the Pledge of Allegiance and remain standing as Mr. Hambright leads us in a sing-along of our national anthem. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. You may now be seated. I apologize, please stand.
Hey, all right, what a special occasion we have here. Look at all you guys, awesome. We're gonna try something a little different this year, and Dr. Pearl and I have been talking about doing something like this for, let me take this off here, for a couple of years. And we said, let's do it this year. So what we're going to try to do is we're going to do a sing-along to the Star Spangled Banner. Does everyone know the words to the Star Spangled Banner? They're in your program. See, we got you.
It's on
Page 3. There's no soloist. There's no backing band. This is called a cappella. All right? And what we are going to have, can we get a couple starting notes over here from the piano? You recognize that? Okay, give us just the starting pitch. That's where we're starting, okay? All right. Okay, I'm going to put this down. Dr. Pearl, would you like to lead us?
No.
I thought I was going to get a break.
All right, I'll do it. Okay, here we go. Can we get the pitch again?
You may now be seated. Please join me in welcoming our current student body president, Angela Ledesma Gratarola.
Good evening. My name is Angela Ledesma Gratarola, and it has been my pleasure to serve as student body president for the 2022-2023 school year. I would like to welcome our parents, relatives, and friends to our graduation ceremony. I know this is a very special day for all of us. I would like to take this opportunity to thank my classmates, the faculty, and staff of Daniel Pearl Magnet High School, and our parents and guardians for their support. Without all of you, this day would not have been possible. Please enjoy this evening's ceremony, and thank you.
And now it is time to enjoy music from some fellow sharks. Come inside my heart and adults are talking.
Hello? Okay, perfect. Okay. Thank you.
please welcome our valedictorian, Delilah Broomer, to share a few words.
Good evening, parents, family, teachers, faculty, and of course, the Daniel Pearl Magnet High School graduating class of 2023. As I stand on this stage, I want to take a moment to acknowledge growth, our growth, as students, as people, as a class. Each and every one of us has exhibited immense perseverance these past 4 years, and as we honor the class of 2023, we should also celebrate the steps it took for us to get here. None of us are the same people we were when we embarked on our freshman years, and how could we be? We've grown through a multitude of challenges, and we've grown stronger at each turn, even if we didn't realize it at the time. Throughout high school, we've endured uncertainty, discomfort, distance learning, and LG tests. And with each challenge, we've grown. Just think about how proud of you your 14-year-old self is right now. I know mine is. In 4 years, we've blossomed into bright, caring, mature young adults. And we didn't do it alone. I'm so grateful to everyone who has supported the class of 2023 and helped us thrive. I'm thankful to our families and support systems who have stood by us and always held us up. To my family, who have shown me love, support, and understanding through my struggles and accomplishments, and who are seeing me off into this next stage of my life. I'm thankful to our friends who have shown us what true camaraderie is. My friends have made high school amazing, and I'm so proud of the young adults they have become. I'm thankful to our teachers who have prepared us for our futures and made DPMHS a second home. To Ms. Hurtado, who ignited my passion for Spanish, even though I can't roll my R's. To Ms. Helfing, who inspired me and made me smile each and every day, even when I didn't do the A-push readings. And to Ms. Shavira, who showed me the power of my voice, who stood up and fought censorship, and who demonstrated to me exactly what true courage is, and who empowered me to pursue journalism. Despite a pandemic, despite our fears or insecurities, despite those in power pushing us down, the class of 2023 has grown and triumphed. As a freshman, I didn't think I'd live long enough to walk up to this graduation stage, but I did. As a sophomore, I didn't think I'd find friends who I could truly be myself with, but I did. As a junior, I didn't think I could rise and be a leader, but I did. As a senior, I didn't think I'd ever be able to leave, but I am. Don't say that we survived, just know that we are living. So here's to spontaneity and thirst, to looking toward the future, but soaking in these moments first. Let's dance and spin and smile, make every single word worthwhile, hold each other and our heads up high as we celebrate this bittersweet goodbye.
And now, let us hear Beat It by members of the DPMHS music program under the leadership of Wes Hambright, our fearless music teacher.
Thank you.
Please welcome our salutatorian, Kennedy Phaeton Guzman, to share a few words.
Good afternoon, beloved staff, esteemed guests, and most of all, the graduating class of 2023. Congratulations to all the seniors sitting in front of me today. All your hard work from the past 4 years of your lives have finally paid off and landed you here today in your cap and gown. Before I begin this speech, I would like to say a few things. First, I want to thank those three who have been such a huge factor in my life, pushing me to always be my best self, even if they did push a bit too far sometimes. My lovely parents, as well as my slightly annoying younger brother, Jack. I'd also like to give a huge thank you to my teammates who have been there no matter the circumstances and would always give me a shoulder to cry on if I ever needed it. We've been through thick and thin, and high school wouldn't have been nearly as bearable without you guys. I would also like to thank the group of seniors who I've gotten so close to this year, especially a certain 6-foot-tall one, as well as his family who was so lovely and welcoming. I'd like to thank all the staff working at Daniel Pearl for doing the best they could to give us a real high school experience, especially Mr. Middlebrook and Mr. Morrison, who helped me find my passion and expand them. I want to acknowledge the lost class of 2023, the 3,044 seniors who were supposed to be graduating with us, but lost their lives due to the countless numbers of gun violence. Congratulations to all those young graduates, and may they rest in peace. It was green and fast. I tried jumping after it and catching it in my hands, but the little thing got away from me before I could even blink. The faster I tried moving my little legs, the faster the grasshopper seemed to move. This was the beginning of a paper I had to write during my first year of public school in the fourth grade. This was also the first paper I'd ever written to get the highest grade in my class, even the highest grade I've ever earned, an A++. The teacher, Mr. Barraza, had talked to me privately soon after that, saying that I had a gift of writing. He told me to keep up the good work, and here I am, 8 years later, talking about him in my salutatorian graduation speech. Transitioning from being homeschooled by myself at my dining room table to attending a school full of children who I'd never seen before and had already formed a friendship group scared me. Yet this teacher gave me the first push on my educational career that made me want to be there and make him proud. Since then, I've been learning and doing well in school for other people. Whether that's my teachers, my friends, the people in my church, especially my parents, because they expected so much out of me, I felt I couldn't let them down. Although I appreciate the efforts all these people made when it came to my education and me doing well, getting good grades for them shouldn't have been my goal. Thinking back to fourth grade, I now understand that I've been striving for perfection all these years. I've been secretly hoping that one day I will get to feel how I did the first time I read my grade on that paper. However, I now know that I was focusing on the wrong subjects, that getting perfect grades wasn't everything. Now, don't think for a second that I'm saying to not get good grades. What I'm saying is that while doing well in school is the main focus, everyone deserves to be fully immersed in the high school experience. Whether that meant hanging out with friends after school at Quickly's or going to the donut shop before school and getting a much-needed coffee while having a conversation with Lucky, the owner there. Being in high school was the last time we got to act like children without being frowned upon by the rest of society. Why am I saying this? Because now, as I'm on the stage in front of my fellow students of the graduating class of 2023, all I'm wishing for is to be able to walk through that gated door in the front of the school again, like it was any other day in the past 4 years. To be able to greet and laugh with my friends and the people I was close with, grades 9 through 12. We all had limited time together at this school without ever really realizing it till now. Let us not make the same mistake in college. Make sure to immerse yourselves in the college experience. Have no regrets. Even though it is scary, this transition from high school to college is the first step of our adulthoods. Every interaction each of us have had with each other has made us grow individually. And now it is time to show off all the things we've learned not only in our high school career, but since the moment we came into this world. From the timeless words of Tupac, the seed must grow regardless of the fact that it's planted in stone. These words remind us of our potential, the limitless possibilities that lie ahead. As we leave the familiarity of high school, we will face new challenges, unfamiliar paths, and moments of doubt. But let us remember that we are resilient seeds blooming in the most unlikely of circumstances. It is our dedication, passion, and unwavering belief in ourselves that will propel us forward. The only thing I can offer now is words of encouragement and advice. So I'll end up by saying the three things I wish for, hope for, and want for each graduating individual here today. I wish for everyone to be the best self they possibly can. To be able to blossom and bloom until each of you is completely satisfied with your identity, who you are as a person, and who you represent. I hope that every important decision and choice you make from here on out is one that you know is 100% for yourself, and not just to try to impress or gain respect from the eyes of others. Lastly, I want for each of you to become rich and famous, as no matter what has happened within the last 4 years, I want everyone here to succeed and live the life they have always imagined. To my fellow graduates, I say, let us take the lessons learned within these halls and let them guide us on our journey to success and happiness. Cherish the memories we've created, the friendships we've forged, and the dreams we've nurtured together. As we step into the world beyond, remember that we are the authors of our own stories. Embrace the challenges, cherish the victories, and continue to grow. Congratulations to us, the class of 2023, and good luck with whatever your future decides to take you.
And now a few words from our 2022 to 2023 student body president, Angela Ledesma Gratarola.
Ladies and gentlemen, distinguished faculty, proud parents, and fellow graduates. Today, we gather to celebrate the remarkable journey of growth and achievement that has brought us to this momentous occasion. As we stand on the threshold of the unknown, eagerly awaiting what lies ahead, we should reflect upon the transformative 4 years we have spent together as a class. Throughout our high school years, we have faced countless challenges and overcome numerous obstacles. We entered the DPMHS hallways as timid freshmen, unsure of what awaited us. But with every passing year, we grew stronger, wiser, and more determined. Today we stand as resilient individuals who have weathered storms and embraced change. Our collective growth is a testament to the incredible strength and resilience within each and every one of us. The road to success is not always smooth or straightforward. It is filled with twists and turns, uncertainty, and moments of doubt. Yet it is within those moments that we discover our true potential. It is in those moments that we find the strength to push forward, to embrace the unknown, and to shine our brightest. I, like many of you, am terrified of the real world that awaits us. And yet, as we embark on this new chapter of our lives, let us remember that the challenges we may face are not obstacles, but opportunities for growth. They are the stepping stones that will lead us to our dreams. On this special day, I want to express my heartfelt gratitude to those who have supported us tirelessly through our high school journey. To our dedicated teachers and staff, you have not only imparted knowledge, but also instilled in us passion for learning and a hunger for success. Your guidance and mentorship has shaped us into the individuals we are today. We owe you a debt of gratitude that can never be fully repaid. To our dear friends, thank you for being there through thick and thin. Throughout my 4 years at Daniel Pearl, I have made so many friends along the way, and they know who they are, but I don't think they understand the effect they've had on my life. They have provided me with a safe haven where I can truly express myself. Your unwavering support, laughter, and camaraderie have been a constant source of strength. The bonds we have forged will withstand the test of time, and the memories we have created will forever hold a special place in my heart. Lastly, to our families, who have been our unwavering pillars of love and support, thank you. You have cheered us on during our successes, wiped away our tears during our failures, and believed in us when we doubted ourselves. Your sacrifices and belief in our potential have been the driving force behind our accomplishments. Today we stand here as a testament to your love and devotion, and trust me, we value and see all of your hard work. I would like to give a special thanks to my mother. You have stood alongside me through thick and thin. I don't think I would have made it this far without you. As I stand before you as your student body president, I am humbled by the opportunity to serve and represent our incredible class. It has been a privilege to lead alongside such talented and inspiring individuals. Together, we have organized events, rallied our classmates, and made our voices heard. As we move forward into the vast unknown, let us remember that our potential knows no bounds. We are equipped with the knowledge, skills, and determination to conquer any challenge that may come our way. Class of 2023, as we bid farewell to the familiar, and embark on a journey of endless possibilities, Let us embrace the unknown with open hearts and open minds. Together, let us continue to shine, to inspire, and to make our mark upon the world. I am confident in the fact that we will all be successful in our future endeavors and complete our future goals with our heads held high, confident in our ability to make a difference. Congratulations, class of 2023. We did it.
And now, a few words from senior Naama Silcott.
Okay, let's do this.
Hello, staff, parents, teachers, and students. My name is Naama Silcott, and I was invited to give a speech at the class of 2023's graduation this evening. Normally, we don't have an opportunity like this, the privilege being saved for the valedictorian and salutatorian. However, Principal Armin Petrosian sent out a message to the class of 23 asking that if any of us wanted to give a speech at graduation, we were to turn something in to Ms. Torres. So I decided, why not give it a shot? Before I get started, I want to take a moment and welcome everyone to just sit in the now. Take a deep breath. We made it. We're here and we made it. As I stand here before my fellow graduates, to-be alumni, and so many other titles that come with the notion that high school is over, I cannot help but think about the Muppet Movie finale song, The Magic Store, and the words Kermit shared. Life's like a movie, write your own ending. Keep believing, keep pretending. At the beginning of my 4 years at Daniel Pearl Magnet High School, those words would have held a different meaning. I remember walking up to just about every one of you, opening with a, I love what you did with your hair, or I want to sit together, I'm a freshman too, because I was absolutely terrified of being one of those early 2000 Disney cliches where I was the quote unquote weird kid. Turns out the script wasn't calling for that at all. I remember having to write a 10,000 word book with Gabby for Mr. Bear's ninth grade honors class and how much fun it was to just collaborate with someone and bring ideas to life. Gabby and I talk about rewriting the book every so often because let's be honest, it's a dumpster fire, but we have to get around to that. I remember my last day practicing track and field right before the pandemic, reaching a new PR, or personal record, of 5'8 for high jump as I got soaked in the pouring rain and the burst of happiness that came with it. I remember the last day of in-person school, how unprepared any of us were for the next school year. During my sophomore year, I'd play Among Us with 15 to 20 other people in a Discord call after Zoom classes would end for the day, and that was one of the ways I got to meet and know some of my closest friends. I sometimes miss those days, although I don't miss my mom threatening to turn off the Wi-Fi with how late I'd stay up laughing my lungs out. On the other hand, 2020 to 2021 were some of the biggest years of loss I've ever experienced. Work ethic, family, friends, identity, the list goes on. The BLM movement helped salvage some of that, giving me purpose when I felt like there wasn't any. From then on, I gained some grounding and began a journey of identity. It wasn't until this year, after heavy denial internally, that I finally figured out I was trans. Something freshman me would have probably go, huh, didn't see that one coming. However, none of these experiences would have shaped me into the person I am today without the people that have pushed me to do the things I would have never had the confidence or courage to do at the start of my 4 years. Thank you, Kiona, someone I often think of as the older sister I never had and my mentor. You pushed me to leave my shell and pursue the things I'm interested in. I would have never kept up with track and field if you weren't there to guide me through it. I would have never went through with Posse and discovered such important connections if you hadn't seen a spark in me when I was a freshman. You set the foundation for key aspects of my high school experience, and I can never stop thanking you enough for all that you've done for me. Thank you to my younger brother, Julian, for growing up with me and teaching me that I still have a lot to learn when it comes to being an older sibling. Thank you to my older brother, Harris, for listening to me ramble, for being open and accepting, for listening, and for being one of my best friends. Your artistic freedom inspires me every day. Thank you to my dad. who works to spend as much time as possible with my siblings and I, supporting me in all my endeavors, getting excited over the small things in life, and making goofy faces with me. Thank you to my mom, who despite everything the rest of us put you through, still take the time to make sure we're okay, who accepted me without a second thought, who accommodates me, who made sure I grew up knowledgeable, loving, and kind. Thank you to everyone here, staff and parents alike, for believing in us, even when the going got tough. You all have done so much for my journey, and I could not be more grateful for the family I was given. Turning my attention to my fellow graduates, this is the part where I give you guys some crazy wise advice and you leave with something inspiring that will hopefully propel you into the next stages of your life, yada, yada, yada. I feel like you guys hear that kind of thing from me all the time anyway, though, so I'm just gonna say one thing, take your time. We're at a turning point in our lives where we're being told all around us to get things done, like final summer vacation as a teen, finalization of paperwork for college, plan things out for the next couple years, know where you want to go. While yes, all of this is very important and you shouldn't leave it off to the side, especially summer vacation, that sounds extremely nice right now. It does not mean that you have to get everything done all at the same time. Take it slow. You have 4 years and also quite literally the rest of your life to figure things out. Not everyone has to be set in stone right this very moment. There's time to explore, to be creative, sad, happy, and everything in between. Find out exactly who you want to be and then settle. Or if not settling is your path, go for it. How you are meant to live your movie, see what I did there? Call back to the opening quote. And how you organize your time isn't up to other people but yourself. Sorry. Even though I set out to leave you with one thing, I managed to turn it into a paragraph of rambling, and for that, I apologize. So with that, just as Kermit's saying at the end of the Muppet movie, a message to all of those that watched this graduating class grow up in the past 4 years. We've done just what we've set out to do, thanks to the lovers, the dreamers, and you.
As you might know, our school is named after Daniel Pearl. Mr. Pearl was a journalist for the Wall Street Journal who lost his life on February 1st, 2002 at the hands of terrorists in Pakistan. We are honored to have here with us today as our keynote speaker, the proud father of Daniel Pearl. Please help me welcome to the podium Dr. Judea Pearl.
Principal Armin, distinguished guests, teachers, families, friends, and the graduate students. Every year, around commencement time, me and my wife Ruth used to be standing here at this stage, congratulating you on your graduation, marveling at your achievements, and looking with amazement at the power of dedication and inspiration that you display on this day. Sadly, Ruth passed away 2 years ago, and I will be trying today for the second time to fill in for her and tell you on this, how this high school has consistently been on her mind and gave her hope and inspiration, even at the most difficult times she went through. Ruth always looked with awe and disbelief at how the legacy of one man, our son Daniel, a former student of this very high school, a product of the same teachers, the same laboratory, same library books, can evoke all this energy and pride, all this accomplishment and commitments to excellence that you radiate on your graduation today. As you and I know, the journalism profession is currently under unprecedented attack. I'm not speaking only about physical attacks, but about the attacks on the very principle of the profession, whose Hippocratic oath is to seek truth and to report it faithfully and credibly. The emergence of fake news or alternative truth, helped by politicians and greedy corporations and social media, has undermined the credibility of the profession to the point where those who seek facts do not really know where to find them. You are probably looking at these developments and asking yourself, will we be able to stop it? Who are we to do it? What is our role in the cosmos? Who said that moving truth from one location to another makes a difference in the world? And who has anointed us with the skills and authority to tell facts from fiction, the essential from the peripheral, and real truth and real news from fake news? Well, at the first memorial ceremony after Danny's death in 2003, a Catholic bishop named David Newhaus made an interesting observation that touches on this very question. What is the modern equivalent of the biblical prophet, he asked. It is the journalist, he answered. Isn't the prophet, like the journalist, one who mediates realities for us? Can Daniel the prophet and Daniel the journalist bear the similar message to us? Isn't the journalist the one who serves today as the moral compass of society? And like the biblical prophet in the ancient street of Jerusalem, is exposing corruption and decrying institutional injustice or ineptness in the modern streets of New York City or Los Angeles? Dear graduates, tomorrow you will be the voice that mediates a reality for us. You will serve as our moral compass. This is your challenge. In the face of this challenge, I would like to add two Daniel Pearl mini oaths to the Hippocratic oath of journalism. First, no matter what area of the world you are reporting on, no matter what conflict you are covering, remember that there are human faces on both sides. Give them voice. Remember Danny's insistence on believing that man is not a predator to another man, but a brother, a kindred spirit. The second mini oath has to do with the audacity to report the truth, even in circumstances when it looks trivial, and especially when it involves speaking to power or risking friendships. I'll tell you another story. It's a story about Danny, as it was told to us a year after his death at the memorial ceremony at North Adams, a little town in Massachusetts where he had his first job as a journalist. At his memorial ceremony, the mayor of North Adams recalled how one day this 20-year-old journalist from California shows up in town and comes to interview him on some irregularities in city's finances. At the end of the conversation, the mayor says to him, "You aren't going to write about it, are you?" And this spoon-fed kid from California answers, "Yes, I am. I am going to write about it." "I almost fell from my chair," said the mayor. "Who does he think he is? If you write about it, you are never going to see me again in this office. But Danny looked him straight in the eyes, smiling shyfully, and said, I am going to write about it, Mr. Mayor, and you are going to see me many, many times in this office. And he was right. He was right on both counts, recalled the mayor. He did publish it. And we had many, many interviews in this office since, and we became good friends too. I don't know where Danny got this fanatic certitude to believe that it is his right, his duty, and in fact his protection to write about what he finds out. But I know where you have gotten your certitude from, the same teachers, the same library books, the same playground that you see around you here in Encino, California, and perhaps even from the name of your school. I now would like to end by wishing you all the luck that you deserve as you begin your journey to dare the impossible. Please remember that the impossible is just an invitation of the possible. Whatever your vocation, be it in business, science, art, or law, Daniel will be there for you. Questioning authority, worship truth, and insist on understanding it in your way. God bless you.
On behalf of the class of 2023, this year's yearbook.
Thank you.
Yes. Thank you.
And now it's my turn to give you back a gift. As used to be our custom before the COVID-19 epidemic, our foundation, the Daniel Pearl Foundation, would like to give fellowship or scholarship to excelling students who is going to pursue work in journalism. And this year, we have chosen a recipient for this scholarship. And we are going to give a scholarship of $2,500 to Dalila Brummer. Who is going to pursue her studies at Northwestern University. Good luck to you, Dalila.
And now it is time to enjoy the last song for the evening, Till Forever, from the DPMHS Music Department.
to love. We've been living on a fault line. And for a while, we were all mine. I've spent a lifetime giving you my heart. I swear that I'll be yours forever till forever falls apart. This is nothing more romantic than dying with your friends, and I'm not sorry for myself. I wouldn't want to spend a minute loving anybody else, 'cause you've got me, you know that I've got you, and I know if the tide takes California, so glad I got to hold ya. And if the sky falls from heaven above, oh, I know I had the best time falling into love. We've been living on a fault line, and for a while you were all mine. I'll spend a lifetime giving you my heart. I swear that I'll be yours forever till forever.
I would like to invite Principal Armin Petrosian to the podium to deliver closing remarks for tonight's ceremony.
Before I deliver the closing remarks, I'd like to recognize some people on stage. We have two special guests with us, Dr. Pearl. We have Community of Schools Administrator, Ms. Deborah McIntyre-Sherino. And we have the extremely hardworking Daniel Pearl Magnet High School teachers, faculty. Please give it up for them. And staff. So American comedy writer Robert Orban quipped that a graduation ceremony was an event where the commencement speaker told thousands of students dressed in identical caps and gowns that individuality was the key to success. Class of 2023, regardless of the identical, well, caps and gowns, you are unique individuals. And each and every single one of you has made a lasting impression on. Class of 2023, here's what I admire about you. I admire your principles and convictions. You didn't back down, and as a freelance writer for the Los Angeles Daily News once said, you weren't afraid to give the adults around you a piece of your mind, and we listened. I admire your grit and persistence. You lived through a global pandemic, excelled, and thrived. And this is my favorite part of the speech. And I'm going to do this every single year, where I get to proudly call out the achievements of the graduating class. One of you was the California Student Journalist of the Year, give it up, and the runner-up for the National Student Journalist Award. Many of you graduated with the California Seal of Biliteracy. 18 of you, roughly about 32%, not that I'm counting, of the graduating class to be exact. Being biliterate is extremely important in today's world. To our competitions at other school, eat your heart out. One of you came to the US as an English learner in April of 2019. And we'll walk across the stage with her four-year cohort. No big, no mean feat. Schools like UCLA, UCLA, Cal, Northwestern will be lucky to have you at their institutions. And all of you decided to continue pursuing higher ed learning, whether at a four-year institution or at a community college.